startup with model 2, losses of pre-stress. As I have covered model 1 completely, go through once and go through the revision, you can do it well. We'll start up with model 2, where model 2 consisting of losses of pre-stress and deflection of the PSEB. So firstly, we'll learn about what are the losses encountered in the PSEB. In this, there are 6 types of the losses you can see here. One is loss of pre-stress due to elastic deformation, loss due to shrinkage, loss due to creep, loss due to relaxation, loss due to anchoring slip, loss due to friction. There are 6 types of the losses encountered in the PSEB. Here, what is this loss? Loss of pre-stress can be estimated by taking the difference in initial pre-stress which is applied minus the effective pre-stress which remained in the beam. This is nothing but the loss of pre-stress. The loss of pre-stress in the member will be occurring due to loss of elastic deformation in the concrete, shrinkage in the concrete, creep in the concrete and relaxation in the concrete, and during the process anchoring slip, if it is taking place, there is a loss of pre-stress. And whenever there is a friction between the surrounding material and the tender, that time also loss of pre-stress will occur. These are the 6 types of the losses, and under this each one we'll study in the detail. First one is loss of pre-stress due to elastic deformation. In exams, you will be asked for what are the losses, how you are going to calculate the different types of the losses. The problem will be asked for calculate the loss due to elastic deformation, shrinkage, creep, relaxation, anchoring slip, friction. Problem may be asked like individual losses can be asked or all together clubbed and total loss will be asked. Again, there is a difference between, you know already, pre-tension member and post-tension member. So losses are also, some losses are common and some losses are very uncommon. Here, losses common in pre-tensioned. If I say about the pre-tensioned beam, the losses are occurring only elastic deformation, shrinkage, creep and relaxation. Okay, there is no loss due to anchoring slip and friction in the pre-tensioned member. In post-tensioned member, there are all the losses are occurring, that is anchoring slip and friction will also come in post-tensioned members. Okay, and here, one more thing, in post-tension member, this is subjected to condition. What is that? Elastic deformation. Whenever the cables are stretched simultaneously, at that time, there is no loss due to elastic deformation in the post-tension member. But when the cables are stretched one by one, there is a loss due to elastic deformation in the PSC member. So, this is subjected to the condition. So, right now, you have to make of the difference between the losses occurred in the pre-tension member and post-tension member. In pre-tension member only there are 4 losses, and in post-tension member all 6 losses will be there, but first one is subjected to the condition. That we learn whenever we go for the problems, at that time it is going to be very clear. Okay, this is about the types of the losses. Right now we will start one by one their introduction about the losses and the respective problem. Okay. Start now. We'll start up with loss of pre-stress due to elastic deformation. So we'll study this about very detail. Pre-tensioned PSEB. When it is pre-tensioned at that time, how to calculate the losses? It is given here. You can see a PSC beam here and a cable here. Pre-stressing force is applied. There is a loss of stress in a PSC member due to elastic deformation in the concrete. Whenever concrete undergoes the elastic deformation, there is a loss of stress in the PSC beam. That is given by loss of pre-stress due to elastic deformation is given by alpha into Fc, where alpha is the modular ratio which is calculated by ES upon EC, where FC is stress in concrete at the level of steel. Wherever the steel is situated at that level, what is the stress? If you are able to calculate this alpha and FC, you can calculate alpha into FC, loss of pre-stress due to elastic deformation. So here ES, sometimes if it is given in the problem. If it is not given, you are able to take it like 2 into 10 raised to 5 Newton per mm square. EC is also, if it is given most of the time, if it is not given, you can take 5700 square root of FCK, where it is mentioned in page number 16, IS 1343. Okay. ES and EC value will give you modular ratio, and the stress in concrete at the level of steel can be calculated like this. You can see this formula. FC equals to P by A plus easiest part here. You have to remember this formula. Alpha into FC will be the loss of pre-stress due to the elastic deformation. So in post-tension beam, just now previously we have learnt about the pre-tension beam. Right now we are shifting to the post-tension beam. In post-tension beam also there is a loss due to elastic deformation, but it is subjected to some conditions here. You need to remember those conditions. In case A, if number of cables are pulled simultaneously, if all the cables are simultaneously stretched or pulled or tensioned, at that time there is no loss due to elastic deformation. You have to remember this point. There is no loss due to the elastic deformation when all the cables are stretched simultaneously. One more case is coming, case B. If cables are pulled one by one, if cables are going to be pulled, suppose there are two or three cables, if they are stretched one by one, first cable is stretched, then second is stretched, then third is stretched, then in that case there is a loss of stress due to elastic deformation will occur. So you need to consider at that time loss of pre-stress due to elastic deformation whenever the cables are stretched one by one. If all the cables are stretched simultaneously, then you have to consider there is no loss due to elastic deformation and it is to be zero. The formula used for both pre-tension and post-tension beam to calculate this elastic deformation is the same formula, that is what? Alpha into FC, where alpha is again modular ratio, FC is the stress in concrete at the level of steel, that is given by the formula P by A or AC it is, plus PEE divided by I minus M by I into E. You already know all the values here, parameters here. P is standing for pre-stressing force, A is for area of concrete, E is for eccentricity, I is moment of inertia, M is the what? Bending moment, I is the moment of inertia, E is again eccentricity in the eccentricity from tendon to the neutral axis. So you have remembered all these things. Right now you have to remember only one thing, that is whenever it is post tension, you have to observe for whether the cables are stretched simultaneously or one by one. Simultaneously means this loss will be zero. If it is one by one, means you have to calculate this by this formula.